Section 8.0, PI interfaces. At this point in class, we like to stop and just ask people to consider what features you would like to see in a properly configured interface. If you have an interface that does everything you think an interface should do, you know, what things would it do? Well, there's a whole laundry list of features we think are very important. Remember, what we're talking about is a data collector in the field that needs to, or a data source in the field that we need to collect data from. So the data is going in this direction toward the PI server. It gets there by means of an interface node, and running on that interface node is an application called the interface. Now, what should that interface be able to do? I mean, for example, if you were to unplug this from the network, just disconnect that in some way, should the interface keep trying to connect to the data source? Well, yes, it should do that. Also, if we disconnect this from the network, should it be able to somehow buffer the data automatically? Well, yes, we think it should be able to buffer the data automatically if for some reason that connection here should fail. So, you know, these are the things that we think are just kind of general things that an interface should be able to do. Let's list them. First of all, it should do automatic point updates. In other words, when you create a PI tag over here on the server, then automatically the interfaces that are affected by that change, we should propagate that change here. So for example, if over here you change from a 1 second scan rate to a 4 second scan rate, then the interface, without having to be stopped and started, should be able to pick that up. So we want automatic point updates. We want local buffering. Again, buffer data over here if we can't send to the server. We would like some kind of error logging to occur, of course. We'd like this to automatically start up as a service. So, you know, the day that, for example, the entire network goes down, every single thing comes down, at some point you bring everything back up. When these come back up and running, when this is back up and running, you would like this to inquire of the server, are you there? So we want it to automatically start up and inquire of the server and then start sending data as soon as it can. So we want an automatic startup after reboot. And we also would like to report by exception. In other words, we only want to receive new data when that data has changed significantly from the previous values. Okay. That's what we mean by reporting by exception or exception testing. So we've considered what a properly configured interface should do. Let's consider for a second what value it would be to you if it could do those kind of things. What types of benefit would it be if all those things were in place? Well, for one thing, you wouldn't get a phone call at 3 a.m. after the system accidentally reboots or loses power. See, auto-starting on reboot, of course, is a feature that's going to save you a lot of trouble. People can create their own tags without your assistance. If there is an auto tag update, it means that after people create these tags, those privileged users, they won't need to bother you and say, can you stop and restart the interface? You can shut down the server without losing data. I tell you, that's a hugely important feature. Now, what we're talking about is that buffering capability. You know, in the previous slide, we described how if the PI server were shut down for whatever reason, when the PI server is shut down, we will automatically buffer data locally. You know, this is the shutdown or this is the disconnect. We'll automatically buffer that, which means, of course, you can shut this server down deliberately. If you want to do a graceful shutdown of this server, then these will buffer data while that shutdown is occurring. Just to let you know, when we first implemented that feature, it was a great boon to system managers because all of a sudden, they didn't have to come in on nights and weekends to upgrade the PI server. See, previous to that, that would be the only time their management would say they were allowed to upgrade it because people were depending on the data being there and they didn't want to lose the data while an upgrade was going on. So that of course is a nice feature. You can troubleshoot with the logs. Of course, if the error logging is occurring, you can log out of the node and the interface continues to run. You know, this is a service. It always starts as a service, so like a good service, it should run whether you're logged in or not. So we're going to discuss how to implement all of these features as we go through and configure the interface. Now, just on a practical note, I should point out that this is the section of the class that I think most people are most anxious about. Will I be able to get the interface to work? So we will definitely go through all the procedures so that you can get this to work when you do this back home. So when you get back home, we would like you to be able to configure your interface the same way we're going to do it in this class. In this class, we're going to use the OPC interface as an example. Okay, it is the most common interface we sell, so it's a very good example to start with. It's likely that you may have an OPC interface. And even if you don't have an OPC interface, the OPC interface uses something called UNIINT, the Universal Interface kind of kernel of core code that all of our interfaces share. So almost everything we do with the OPC interface, you're going to be doing something very similar when using your or configuring your own interface. So that's why we use this example. So this UNIINT is going to be configured, the UNIINT-based interface will be configured very similar to the one we're using as the example.